Hello and welcome to Designing. This is the seventh in a series of tutorials where we are setting up an interior design dashboard in Notion. If you've missed the first six tutorials, you should check those out so that you can build along. Once I've finished building the dashboard, I'll make a template available. So if you'd like one, sign up in the description. If you don't want to miss a video, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Anyway, let's get started. In this tutorial, we are going to build out a project's database. We're using exactly the same process that we have used before, creating properties and linking them to existing databases. Next, we are going to start building a new project template. This template will be kept in the standard operating procedure database, duplicated, and then moved into our project portal. Let me take you for a tour. In this tutorial, we're going to start looking at projects. The first thing we're going to do is create this project's database. This is a separate database, and we're going to create it exactly the same way we've created it before. We have the name of the project, and we also usually, well, I do in my practice, give my project a code. This is the code that I might give to suppliers, for example, if they need a reference. I also add in the client name, but I also add in the relationship to the client database, to the contact database. So this is actually just linked to the page. And then we've got the type of project. We've got the address, and this is just really for quick reference. Then we've got the type of project, the date it is created, the lead designers, and then we can include the project portals, any interior design materials that we have. We're going to create this database a bit later. And then we can also create standard operating procedures that we might need for our project. So later on, we're going to come back into this project's database and do a little bit more linking. The next part is creating a new project template. This template is actually created within our standard operating procedures. And the intention is that if you create it within your standard operating procedures, you can duplicate it and then move it into the correct position. So this is the template and it's internal. And we have very, very similar details to what we have created before. This is just for your reference. We've got our properties. We've got the type. We want to make sure it's a client. Then, of course, we've got our project galleries and we can link the project that we've created. This is from our project database. Then we have our last update. Then we can add in our contacts, knowledge base, links database, or standard operating procedures. We know who it created. And then this will eventually become a database as well. And the reason that I'm not linking it to the status is that for each project, we're going to create a new database, which is linked to the tasks that is part of that project. We have the stage, which we will link into another database, which has the different options in terms of the status of the project. And this status can be however you like to look at the status. So we need to split our project into stages, and each stage is split into actions, and you can be as detailed as you would like here. Now, the idea here is not to move these along, but know as we're working through our project that we can actually make notes and we can create templates for each of these, which we will do in the standard operating procedure and then which will be copied. Now, I haven't filled out all of these. You can see that there's a few things. So we've got set up your client, however you'd like to communicate with them. And then we've got all these things here. If you've got different steps, I could say here we have send client onboarding document doc. So I can just go in and make that. So I might put that here. So I have the consultation phase checklist. You can create a template for each of these. Then we have the inquiry call, and then you can write some notes here. Then you've got the onboarding document. You might have a copy of that onboarding document that you can then easily download. So all of this is part of a standard operating procedure. And really what you're trying to do is for each of these stages, there actually should be a separate standard operating procedure page that we can then link. We can actually have a standard operating, so we can add a property, we want a relationship, and we want to link it to our standard operating procedures. We can just go into our standard operating procedures, copy whatever we need to do and enter it into here so that no one is kind of lost as to what is able to do. So the way that I've split this up is I have divided it into seven stages. But there are many ways to split up projects into stages. We have a few ways that we can measure the stages of the interior design client experience. I've seen some split into four. Then you can have ones that are split into many pages. If you're in the UK, you might be familiar with the RIBA plan of work framework and you may follow that. And this is actually quite a long path. Or if you're in the US, you might know Kimberly Seldon's Business of Design workflow, which is a 15-step workflow. So whatever step you take, you can actually adapt it to your workflow. So let's just head back into this new project. And I've just split this into seven. But if you actually have a look in this, you'll see elements of both the RIBA and the Business of Design workflow in here. Now you can just customize this however you like. I just created another database and we've split it into three so we can have dates. So for example, I can actually put in a date here and then this date will appear on this milestone. And then here I've got a table view and we can again organize this however we want. You can just go sort descending here or you can look at the status. Let's say, let's go add a sort and we're going to go the status and ascending. So then you can have all these statuses, can then pull this in and we can grab the list of status if we want to just tick it off. You can even do something like a completion checkbox. So we can say here it is completed. So when we've actually finished it, we can just tick it off and go from there. You could give each of these stages a number if you would like to make it even more organized. So this is quite a way of looking at your projects. Now later on, we're going to come back to this project. So in the next tutorial, what we're going to do is actually look into linking these stages into tasks. So let's just have a look at our status. Here are statuses. So we have our initial consultation. You can see here is the 15 steps from the Business of Design. You have your initial consultation, you have the signing of contract, trade day, and so on. And you can see that all of these stages are linked to these four databases. So we want to make sure when we go back, actually linking it into these databases as much as possible. So you can see here we've linked it all and then we can make sure that we have full control over where we are within this section. So in the next tutorial, we're going to start looking at tasks and task management. And we've now created quite a few templates. And so we've got our new project template. We've got our projects, which we've set. We've got our project portal for clients. We've got our MasterLinks database, our standard operating procedure database, our CRM pipeline, which is just a view of our contacts database. We've got our quick links here. We've got our knowledge base, which we've set up. And then we also have views of this contacts database. In the next tutorial, we're going to start looking at tasks and goals. We're going to look at the high level goals that we might want to achieve and how we link to those, as well as our tasks on a daily basis. So one of the things we're going to look at is linking it to the projects that we've already created.
I can't wait to show you and to get started. See you in the next video.